In this video, we will go over the basics of municipal wastewater treatment. In other words, how do we take water that looks like this and make it look more like this? Typically, when discussing this subject, we find ourselves staring at a pretty complex and confusing flow diagram. However, for this video, we're going to use a much more simplified version depicted here, which has three basic paths. Raw water from homes, businesses, and industries enters here. Garbage and miscellaneous materials follow this path, eventually leading to a landfill. Water follows this path and is either discharged to a receiving water body, like lakes and rivers, or utilized for some form of beneficial reuse, such as irrigation, or even to be used as drinking water. And biological solids follow this path and end up either in a landfill or some form of beneficial reuse, such as fertilizer. Before we go into any more detail on the flow diagram, let's first take a step back and look at what exactly we're treating and why. In this tank, we'll take a look at what makes up most municipal wastewater. The first and most prominent component is water. Our goal in this entire process is to separate this water from all the other stuff in the wastewater stream. Next, we have all the non-biological solids that find their way into our waste stream. This includes garbage, toilet paper, sticks and stones, and all the other lovely things you can imagine. Without treatment, these items would find their way into our waterways and drinking water supplies. Then we have what comes to most people's mind when they hear about wastewater: unstabilized biological material, which is poop, mostly. On its own, this is 100% natural. When dispersed throughout nature, it is a critical part of life. So when a bear does what it does in the woods, it's perfectly fine. The issue comes when we collect the material of a large population, then discharge it into a single place. Now, that biological material that is a great source of food for life is displaced and concentrated, which causes uncontrolled microbial growth. Again, these microbes are natural and harmless, except in large quantities. When this happens, they will use up all the oxygen in the water and kill fish and plant life. Now, back to the soup we've been cooking. The next ingredients are the various inert solids that are suspended in water, known as suspended solids. Creative name, right? If untreated, these would cloud up the water of receiving bodies, limiting light to, and therefore killing, plant life, which is why we need to remove them. Suspended solids are measured in terms of total suspended solids, or TSS, which is the dry weight of solids in a set volume of water, or by turbidity, which is a measure of the refraction of light off said particles. The next components we are going to discuss are nitrogen and phosphorus, or known collectively simply as nutrients. These are both naturally occurring and vital to life, and are produced in the waste of people and animals. But much like biological solids, when collected from a large population and then discharged into a water body, they create too much of the wrong kind of life in the wrong place. In this case, algae blooms, which block out light and use up oxygen, killing the aquatic plants and animals. Nutrients aren't regulated nationwide at this time, but are increasingly added to regulations as their effects occur in various water bodies. And the last guests to our party are pathogens and viruses. Why they're bad and why we have to treat them is pretty straightforward. They make us sick, so we have to kill them before discharging any water from a plant. And with that, we have our complete cast of characters for this introduction to wastewater treatment. Now that we know what we have to treat and why we have to treat it, we need to look at how we treat it. In the next video, we will begin to take a look at how the various steps in our sleek new treatment schematic treat each of these items we discussed here today. This video was brought to you by the innovative engineers at Parkson. Click here for the next video in this series. And if you found this video helpful, please be sure to like and share. If there's anything water or wastewater related you'd like to see in a future video, be sure to let us know in the comments section, or on our Facebook, LinkedIn, or Twitter pages.